This is truly the real estate business. And especially for those of you guys that are brand new, I want you to totally understand this. And whether we're talking about you guys are realtors, the real estate business, or we're talking about investors, the real estate investing business, so many times people get too hung up on the real estate side. And I'm not saying that part is not important. Of course, it's essential. You have to understand how to wholesale, how to write a contract, how to flip, how to rehab, how to market things, how to put things in place so that buyers will be interested in your properties, how to do lease options, like all of the technicals and the stuff that we've taught for years that are all on the website. All of that stuff is important, right? But I got to tell you is that the real estate business, the business side, is just as important as the real estate side. And those are two skill sets that you need to be, if you want to be able to scale. Now listen, if you're just kind of playing at it, it's just kind of a hobby, then it can be a real estate hobby. It can be a real estate fun and games. But if it's something you want to scale to a place where it's either going to get you out of your job or build significant wealth or put you in a position where you can kind of change your financial future with your family or any of those type of things, you are going to have to understand it, see it, view it, practice it, study it as not just real estate, but as the business, right? So we're talking about outsourcing and delegation and time management and cash flow management. All those other skills that are necessary are super critical for you to learn, because I've been doing this long enough to understand that just the knowledge of real estate is not enough to allow you to scale and grow a business of any significant size, okay? You got to understand real estate, you got to understand business, and under that heading, under that category of understanding business, is understanding the importance of a marketing plan. Okay, the critical nature of a marketing plan. Again, I don't know of any business of any significant size or income or worth or anything that doesn't have a high octane marketing plan. Now again, going back to what I said at the beginning, marketing doesn't necessarily mean advertising. Doesn't mean that you're necessarily got a billboard every 100 yards like Alexander Shinara, okay? That's his plan. That doesn't necessarily have to be your plan. Again, if you go back, if all you want to do is word of mouth, that's fine. If that's going to be your marketing plan, but again, it has to be a plan. You have to have a systematic approach to being able to ask for referrals and follow up on those referrals and provide good enough, amazing service and creating raving fans so that they'll even give you referrals. Like all of that is a part of it. Even going back to Bob and Jeremy, no, they're not sending out yellow and black postcards that say we buy apartment complexes cash, right? They're in the commercial space. They do apartments and mobile home parks and all that kind of stuff. So no, that's not it. But their plan still involves cultivating relationships with private investors and investors in their deals and being able to provide good returns so that those people will come back and repeat and networking and connecting with brokers systematically so that they find those deals and they stay top of mind. And so all of that stuff matters and all of that stuff is important.